The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Behold the handmaid of the Lord,
being done unto me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And the word was made flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray.
Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Please turn to your missal or to the parish newsletter as we pray together the entrance antiphon. As for me, in justice I shall behold your face. I shall be filled with the vision of your Lord. Welcome to this Mass of the 15th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Today we're privileged to have as the Gospel the Good Samaritan, and so it reminds us that so much of Jesus' public ministry was showing the compassion of the Father to people of the day and inviting us to follow. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to our videographer, William, who is live streaming this Mass, and to those who are watching on live stream. As we prepare ourselves to celebrate this sacred mystery, let us first pause and call to mind our sinful song. Lord Jesus, you are the mercy of the Father, made manifest to us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are our good shepherd, leading us to everlasting life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come to us in your word, in your sacrament. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Please join in the prayer of praise. Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord of Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world,
grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it right. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
What's written in the law? What do you read? "Who is my neighbor?" Jesus replied, "A man was once on his way down from Jerusalem to Jericho and fell into the hands of robbers. They took all he had, beat him, and then made off, leaving him half dead. Now a priest happened to be travelling down the same road, but when he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. In the same way, a Levite came to the place with him and passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan traveller who came upon him and was moved with compassion when he saw him, he went up and bandaged his wounds, pouring oil and wine on him. Then he lifted him on his own account, carried him to the inn, and looked after him. Next day, he took out 2 denarii and handed them to the innkeeper. 'Look after him,' he said, 'and on my way back, I will make good any extra expense you have.' Which of these 3 do you think proved himself a neighbor to the man who fell into the brigand's hands?" "The one who took pity on him," he replied. Jesus said to him, "Go and do the same yourself." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Our 3 readings today all work in some unison. So we notice that the first reading is from the book of Deuteronomy. It seems that this was the discovery of a law, a book of the law, that probably had been buried to hide it in the 587 BC. March of the Babylonians and their destruction of Jerusalem. And so Moses says to the people, recounting what was given to him by God, which we know as the 10 Commandments. And then we come to today's Gospel reading. This road between Jerusalem and Jericho is a most remote road, and the people who heard the parable and the account of the Good Samaritan would know it well. They would travel together like a caravan for mutual protection. But we notice that this man falls into the hands of brigands, and they take all he had, they beat him, and leave him half dead. And then the lawyer who asked Jesus as a test, is, "What must I do to inherit eternal life?" Now, as a lawyer, he should know that very well. So what he repeats is actually the Jewish prayer, daily prayer, which would be the equivalent of our making the sign of the cross before any prayer. And this Shema would be well known to Jesus' hearers and to the lawyer himself. But notice how there's a context. He asks Jesus this question publicly, and he is wondering how Jesus will get out of the question that he's posed. So Jesus then gives the account of this man who has the misfortune to fall into the hands of brigands. And the 2 who come along first, the priest and the Levite, you would expect them to know the law and to put it into practice. So why do they not come to the aid of this man in the parable? Because Jesus finds fault with the law. So the law would say, the priest
makes himself ritually unclean. And Jesus would see this in his response to the lawyer as part of the deficiency of the law, because it looks on externals and not the things of the heart, where compassion comes from. And the response that Jesus gives at the end, go and do the same yourself. So it's not sufficient to know what the right thing to do is. It's the putting into practice of a very public way of Jesus stating the deficiency of the law on one hand and the perfection of his teaching on the other. Then if we look at the second reading from St. Paul to the Colossians, this is a letter that has an almost cosmic view. And so it says that Jesus Christ is the Lord of all creation, and that through being raised up by the Father's power, he is now Lord of heaven and earth. The town of Colossae, where Paul preached the gospel and who heard this, would be, with Ephesus, two large cities of their day. In fact, after Rome, the two larger cities in the time of Jesus. They would be about one-sixth of the population of Perth today. So we have Paul enunciating his vision of Jesus as the Lord of all creation. And let us then, as we hear this gospel today, it's part of Jesus preparing his disciples for the mission that he's sending them out two by two to proclaim the good news of the gospel. And next week will be somewhat similar as well. So as we hear this gospel today, let us pray that we will have the strength to follow Jesus, his compassion, and his love throughout his public ministry.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord would give Christ to the poor, the sick, the dying.
Lillian Sewell, Anthony now diagnosed with leukemia with his wife Beverly in O'Holland, receiving non-human sickness of the immune component. John Caden, now in the Newton Hospital, and Michael O'Loughlin. We pray for their recovery.
Lord,
we pray for them.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice be pleasing in your sight, Lord God. Lord, wash away my iniquity, cleanse me of my sin. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. In our Mass this morning, we'll have the seventh preface for Sunday and the third Eucharistic prayer. Look upon the offerings of the Church, O Lord, as we make her prayer to you. Grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is
right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world, that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin. So that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victor, by whose death you will to reconcile the world to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Columba and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Timothy our Bishop and Donald his assistant bishop, listen graciously to the prayers of this man, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, glory and honour is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
The apostles asked Jesus to teach them to pray. So let us pray the prayer he gave them and through them to us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our lives, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always." Now, with a profound bow, let us offer each other the sign. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. Holy Spirit of Pentecost. Come, Holy Spirit of the great sacrament. O God, bless and unite all your people in this prayer, and guide us on the pilgrim way to the living council. Give us the grace to see your face in my heart, and to recognize Jesus as our companion and Lord. Give us the courage to tell our stories, and to speak boldly with your truth. Give us ears to listen humbly to each other, and discern our heart to hear what you would say. Lead your church into a hope-filled future, that we may live the joy of the gospel. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, pray for the journey from age to age. Amen. Our Lady of Christians,
pray for us.
Saint Mary of the Cross, make it.
Pray for us.
And now, as the second of church collection is taken up, I'll draw your attention to some of the notices. Firstly, it's normally on the first Sunday of the month that we have a retiring collection for the Altar Society. But when that was came, we were having the soup fundraiser for the Social Committee, so we delayed the Altar Society retiring collection until today. I wonder what the collection goes to pay for, especially the host and the altar line, and for some of the restoration of the church. But some of those are the two former water stoops on the outside of the main door. They were very oxidized copper. Now the oxidization has been removed. Some of the originals have said they look like new. And similarly, the old water stoop here. It was a good time to do this restoration because at the moment, during COVID, we were not having the holy water. And those of you who may wish to donate to the restoration appeal, which because it's registered with the National Trust, it attracts tax deductibility. So beside the St. Patrick statue there are envelopes for the appeal, or in the middle column of your newsletter, there is another way that you can make your donation online, and how to make checks payable to the National Trust. Tomorrow is the feast of St. Benedict, and our archdiocese have at least two Benedictines who came with the first Bishop of Perth, John Brady, in landing in January 1846. And Bishop Salvado, as he later became, was the principal one involved at New Nelson. I remember as a young priest taking the youth group on an excursion to New Nelson, and Father this large altar mystery at a painting by Vincent van Gogh of the Good Samaritan. So this is one of the few religious works that Vincent van Gogh painted, and he suffered, the poor man, a mental illness which descended on him, and he was helped by his brother Theo in those times. So Theo certainly proved himself a neighbour to his brother. Let us stand.
Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
After Mass today, our acolyte Bernard will go and visit Barry and June Kirtboys nursing home and our parishioner Lillian Simeon. So go with our prayers and blessing. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Now I'm turning the missal around, featuring Vincent van Gogh's painting of the Good Samaritan. Welcome.